coming off the boat and practically right on your table. I mean, it's so fresh.
Go direct to the consumer, right from the Gloucester fishermen.
They can't get this quality fish, this taste, and because they haven't tasted it before, it's something that blows their mind.
Frank Ragusa knows fishing and fish. A third-generation Gloucester fisherman, he worries that the strict catch limits and boat buyback programs of the past three decades have, frankly, ruined the New England palate.
We've got a generation, maybe two, that doesn't know what fresh fish tastes like anymore. Because when this industry went away for fresh New England fish, we were forced to turn to previously frozen, refresh, whatever you want to call it, from other countries.
But Ragusa and local Gloucester fishermen say the fishery is healthy, and many of the fish are now back in big numbers.
When it was in decline, there was plenty of press. But there hasn't really been any press that this fish is here and these fishermen have survived.
So Frank and others started Ocean's Table, fresh from the boat, overnight delivery of seafood, in an effort to re-educate New England consumers. Lou Imbriano brought his marketing and business expertise to the group.
When you buy from some grocery store or some local shop, you don't know how long it's been there, you don't know if it's been treated, you don't know if it's been frozen. Our process is to make sure that it's completely fresh. It is never treated, it's never frozen, and we take out all the middlemen.
As the day's catch comes off the boats, it's sorted and then moved to the cutting room, where it's carefully cut and cleaned. Then the fish is quickly packed, vacuum sealed, and shipped at just the right temperature to keep it fresh until it arrives at the customer's doorstep the next day. Christian Christensen runs the Cape Ann Seafood Exchange, which provides space for Ocean's Table.
I don't think we've had one customer complaint about quality of the fish. People love it. They say they never tasted fish like this before in their lives.
Deliveries started in January, and they already have more than 1,000 customers from New England, south to the Carolinas and Florida, and west to Illinois. And they acknowledge riding the wave of the farm-to-table movement.
This new generation of consumer wants to know who raised their beef, who grew their vegetables, where was the farm. Every label has the boat that landed it, the port it landed, the captain. We can tell you where they fished, we can tell you what they had for dinner. But this is what today's consumer wants to know. They want to feel that connection. And Ocean's Table provides that.
Customers get an email each week telling them what is fresh off the boat and giving them several ordering options. And the folks at Ocean's Table are convinced that once you've tried their seafood, you'll be the one who is hooked.
We already know. If you taste it, it's done. It's over. The rubber meets the road when the fork meets the tongue. It's done.
The Seafood Expo in Boston, the largest event of its kind in North America, and this year, witness to the biggest thing to happen to tuna since the can.
There really hasn't been any innovation in the tuna category for about 50 years. There's canned tuna, the comfort food that we mix with mayonnaise and have on a sandwich that we all love, right? And then there's sort of sushi-grade tuna or high-end ahi tuna that we cook with. This product lands right in the middle.
Call this the biggest thing since sliced bread, because it is literally sliced tuna. It's the result of a somewhat happy accident from the innovation group at Thai Union, parent of Chicken of the Sea and the largest tuna provider in the world. They were hoping to extend shelf life with high pressure processing, but instead,
they found that it actually changed in the texture and property of product itself. So when we test the product, first of all, we found out it doesn't really smell like fish anymore. So it's kind of like, wow, why is that? And we start to slice it up, and we say, wow, this can be really interesting.
Interesting enough to win a Best New Product Award at the Expo. It's a yellowfin tuna loin infused with marinade under high pressure, which cooks the tuna. It will be sliced and sold in deli departments, and it solves one of the age-old problems of the tuna sandwich.
People told me that they want to bring tuna sandwich to the kids for lunch sandwich. By the time it gets to lunch, it's soggy, right? So I think this product is going to be fixing all those problems they have.
Tuna fishing, of course, is not without controversy amid concerns about bycatch, dolphin and other marine life caught unintentionally while fishing for tuna. But Thai Union has won praise from Greenpeace for its sustainability practices.
The tuna commitment that we have specifically is the leading commitment in the industry as far as how to source tuna responsibly And what we're working towards is overall having all of our tuna meet Marine Stewardship Council certification requirements. This is the leading standard in sustainability for wild caught fishing.
Thai Union says this new product will not place any additional strain on the overall tuna stock since it is made from their existing catch, which may be a good thing since this could be the next big thing on your plate.
I think once people taste this, they get really excited. That's the reaction we're having at the show. Everybody that tastes it just loves it.
It did look good, and Thai Union is actually rolling out a new variety of their tuna.
Already, it's flavor infused, so basically they take the ready-to-eat tuna that we just saw and they're infusing that with different flavorings. Also, back to Ocean's Table, next month they're going to start rolling out some new variety packs, larger variety packs for customers, and some new delivery options as well. So both of them are advancing in the right direction, it seems like.
Craving a clam bake, we found one with a view.
It's got all the great New England ingredients,